Google Tasks has come an awful long way over the last few years, and in particular over the last few months, as they have added new features to help you and I be more productive. So in today's video, I want to share with you my 5 favorite tips so you can get so much more out of Google Tasks. Hello everyone, Scott Friesen here at Simpletivity, helping you to get more done and enjoy less stress. And let's jump right into tip number 1. Now this is something that is more recent, so you may not be familiar with these first 2 tips. The first thing that Google Tasks has added recently is the ability to have repeating tasks. So I'm going to add a task here, and let's just do something really, really basic, like take out the garbage, something that I certainly need to do on a regular basis. But before I hit enter, I'm going to edit this particular task, and you will see that I have the ability to add a date and a time. We want to start with that, and I want to do this every Sunday. Sunday evening is when I want to take out the trash. But you can see at the bottom that there is now a repeat function. So I can choose to have this task happen each and every Sunday. I'm going to select that, and I've got multiple choices if I want to do it by day, week, month, or year. In this case, I want to do it every week, and I want it to appear on the Sunday. I want to start it on May 26. I can change that there if I want to. I'm going to leave the time alone, so it's just going to appear at the beginning of May 26th, the beginning of Sunday, and I'm going to select OK. And so now we have it there. If I go back to my task list, yes, it's going to appear for this coming Sunday, May 26th, but the great thing is I can see the little icon. It's telling me that it's a recurring task. This time, if I go and mark it as complete, it is now gone from my task list, but yes, it will reappear here in the coming Sunday. So it's always going to come and show up when I have that repeating task. Of course, we always have the completed area down below here, so I can always go back in here. And if I want to remove that repeater, that's where I would want to go, into this completed area, and then I can remove future completed tasks. But let me minimize that for now, and let's get to tip number 2, which is also something which is rather recent, something that was recently added, and that's the ability to add a specific due time, not just a due date, but a due time. So let's say I want to email Susan later in the day. First of all, if I'm going to update my time here, this is something way in the past, so let me bring it up to something a little more current. Let's say I'm going to email her tomorrow morning, but I don't want to just set it for the 22nd. I want to make sure I do this before noon. So I'm actually going to come down here and select set time. I can either enter it in from a text-based perspective, or I can just punch it in. I'm going to say 9:30 a.m., and I'm going to say OK. Now, the great thing with this is that I will have, there you can see it, it's just popped up here to the left on my calendar. It will appear on my calendar as well. As long as I have my tasks calendar enabled down here within Google Calendar, anything with a specific time will also show up here within that calendar. So not only will I receive a reminder, but I'll see it there on my calendar as well. So another helpful addition, something that Google Tasks has added recently. Tip number 3 has to do with using subtasks. In many cases, you may be managing a project or even just a mini project here within Google Tasks. So I'm going to say, let's just call this one mini project for our example, shall we? What I'm going to do this time around, I'm going to hit the edit button, and we can see below add date and time, there's the ability to add subtasks. So I'm going to say this is mini task 1, really original, Scott, mini task 2, and mini task 3. So I can have these other additional tasks. These things all work their way up or all a part of this mini project. I can add them here within my task list. So something very, very powerful. Now, when you see the front of the task, what you'll notice is that they do appear as individual tasks. This is actually quite helpful because I can now go into mini task 1, for example, and I can give it a distinct due date. I can give more details, right? Specific details for this particular task as well. But it will keep them together. So for example, if I want to, let's give this a due date, right? Let's give the mini project a due date, for example, of let's say like maybe the next end of next week. I'm going to come back out here as well. So here you can see that that mini project there. They're still attached, even though these ones have no due date, right? These are the subtasks. They are still joined. If I open up this this mini task here, I can still deal with it the way I want to, but it's still attached to this mini project up above. There you see all three of our tasks here below, and I can start checking them off. Probably would have done task one first, but let's say I did number task two first. I can see them all here within that mini project. All right, tip number three has to do with something that I'm sometimes surprised that I have to remind so many people about, but it's very, very helpful, is don't forget that you can use more than just one list within Google Tasks. By default, Google's going to create this My Tasks list, but you can see here I have a new project list, and I can create something else as well. Let's say, let's call this one the Brand New List, for example. And I can hit done. So I can separate my personal from my business. Here's my brand new list. I've got nothing in here just yet. So maybe I wanna start out, and I'm gonna say new task for Monday. Okay, so I've got my brand new task in here, but let's say that I created it here and then I forgot. Oh no. Brand new task list. I don't want it here. I actually wanted it in my tasks list. Well, it's actually pretty simple. If you go into the edit function here, you can see you can change the list down below. Right below the details, you can always move your tasks in between different lists. So in this case, maybe I put it here by mistake. I'm going to say, let's put it back into my tasks. If I come back out, this is empty once again. And now I can go back here and find that one under my tasks. I didn't give it a due date, right? There's my new task for Monday, so I can find it down below as well. Well, the last task I wanted to share with you today is maybe one of my favorites and something that you'll find very, very powerful. It has to do with using Google Tasks with Gmail. So if I go over here to Gmail, often we want to convert a particular email into a task, and we can do that quite easily. Up near the top of any of your emails, you'll find the little three dots. It gives us some more options, and here we have a choice to add it to tasks. So you can see it's automatically going to open up my tasks bar here, and it's going to add this particular task. Now it's going to use the label here. Here we go, under no date. It's going to use the subject line of the email. It's going to give that the title of the task. So winter is gone. Something that I want to do here with this this sheet go notification. Maybe there's some things that I want to look at here. Now of course I can come in here and I can relabel this, right? I can say let's just call this sheet go tasks to complete. Something like that. And I can add further details if I want to, but the real bonus, the real plus here is that it gives me a direct link to this email. So if I go back out here, you can also see that from the front, and in fact I can access it from the front as well. So I'm going to just click on my inbox. I'm going to get out of this particular email here just to show you an example. So let's say as I'm going through my to-do list, I come across this one and say, oh yeah, I want to review what were those tasks in that email. I'm just going to click on this link, and immediately that email will appear here on the left-hand side of the screen. So really powerful if you want to automatically attach an email to a particular task. You can convert it by just using the more options and selecting add to tasks. Well, I would love to hear from you next. Of these five, which one was your favorite? Which one do you find is going to be most useful for you? And do you have some additional tips that you'd like to share with others? Please be sure to add them in the comments down below. Remember, being productive does not need to be difficult. In fact, it's very simple.